The topic I will be delving into today is the concept of trust and faith. But before we get into the devotions, can we pause for a moment of prayer? Father, we give you thanks. Father, we give you praise. Father, we give you honor. Father, we give you glory. This is the day the Lord has made. We will rejoice and be glad in it. Father, I want to thank you today for bringing us together on this forum from all points of the world. Father, we give you thanks for Sister Angela and her team. And as we go into these devotions, oh God, I'm trusting, I'm praying, and I'm hoping that something that goes forth from this devotion today will touch some soul. In Jesus' name, I pray. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, God. Amen, amen, and amen. Bless the Lord. Yes, so the topic we will be looking at today is the concept of trust and faith. Trust is a choice. Proverbs 3, 5, and 6 tells us, trust in the Lord with all thine heart, and lean not unto thine own understanding. In all thy ways acknowledge him, and he shall direct thy paths. Family, trust matters. So ask yourself the question, who do I trust, or who places their trust in me? Trust is an important concept in relationships. Where there is trust, there is great value and the potential for much more. Trust removes friction. There is no room for contention. Do you agree? Family, let's get real. No amount of money can buy trust or force it to exist. Our trust in others and their trust in us can only be built with time, with honesty, and with earnest intentions. Saints in Christ, today, I encourage you to put your trust in God, even when it does not make sense to you. Here are some tips to building trust in our relationships. 1, be true to your word. 2, be honest. 3, be consistent. 4, do what you believe is right. And 5, admit your mistakes. Psalm 37, verses 3 and 4 tells us, trust in the Lord and do good. So shalt thou dwell in the land, and verily thou shalt be fed. Delight thyself in the Lord, and he shall give thee the desires of thine heart. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Friends, we have a Heavenly Father right here saying, do you want my help? And we just have to say, we want your help, Lord, and trust that he can do what he needs to do. Family, let God do the work that needs to be done in your life. Amen. It's amazing. The problems that are solved the moment we decide to trust God in everything. Because when we trust God, we don't need to figure things out anymore. As we lean on God, we take the pressure off ourselves. Simply trust God with any situation we face in life and watch him solve all our problems. Nothing is too little or too big for Jesus to handle. He is bigger than all our problems. Thank you. Thank you, Jesus. What a privilege. What a privilege. Now, let's turn our attention to faith. Faith is inseparable from trust. It's the confidence that God can and will do what he says in his word. Romans 10:17 states, faith comes by hearing, and hearing by the word of God. Faith is a promise. We cannot know all the answers yet. We can have faith that the answers we seek do exist. Faith keeps us as believers going when logic and reason have failed us. The songwriter says, hold on in faith and God will give you guidance. Faith gives us a deeper, more sustained access to strength than would otherwise be possible. The scripture tells us, speak and the mountains will move. Anything we ask, our God can do. Sometimes it is easy to forget that the God we ask to guide us through our day-to-day life is also the God who made the sun to stand still. Saints in Christ, if you have faith in God, you are God's friend. The Bible says, God is a friend that sticks closer than a brother. That means he is faithful. He will never leave you and he will never forsake you. Family, it is an honor and a privilege to be called God's friend. It takes strength to stay in faith. Sometimes it is hard to relinquish control, but until we do, we will never see all that is in Jesus for us. Faith is a promise we can embrace and in our intimate realm. And often such a promise is exactly what we need. Hebrews 11:1 states, now, faith is the substance of things hoped for, the evidence of things not seen. Having faith in something means trusting it completely. People with strong faith are confident that they can do anything they set their minds to do. What a blessing. What a blessing. In closing, saints in Christ, I challenge you today to seek God's help to enable trust and faith to flourish on your spiritual journey. Trust and obey. For there is no other way to be happy in Jesus but to trust and obey. Family, let's speak words in faith, believing for positive outcomes. Philippians 4:13 tells us, I can do all things through Christ who strengthened me. Family, let's aspire to become the best version of yourselves through Jesus Christ. May the blessings of the Lord be upon us all. Thanks for listening. Have an awesome day. And Sister Angela, it's been a privilege to share, and I'm trusting and hoping that as you continue in this ministry, that the Lord will lift you to higher heights. Be blessed. Love you lots and all the best. Bye for now.